Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Path, Tome 1, The Chaos, which I bought here in the Ark Library in the Noble's Quarter. The Path, Tome 1, The Chaos. Verse 1. Long ago, while the world was still unriven, it was called Pangora. Pangora was great and mighty, and reached from mighty Calais to Enderal. But all life faded away, as it was under no man's reign, and ruins are all that remained of the old ones, the Pyreans. And so it would have remained, if Asateron had not come into being. The first Eterna, the Scourge of the Ash, the malevolent sovereign of those early days. Verse 2. In the first centuries, Asateron roamed Pangora alone and shaped the world to his liking. However, he was cruel and heartless and thirsted after pain and suffering. He created two men, one from ash and one from his own blood. The blood men he called Eterna, for he gifted them with longevity and magical power. The men of ash were weak and ephemeral and were created by Asateron to serve not just the Eterna, but Asateron himself, who stood above all things. Verse 3. Under the scourge of Asateron and his servants, the Ashmen erected buildings and cities. Great was the suffering the Ashmen had to endure. Yet with each passing year, Asateron's vile madness grew until his hatred began to spread not only to the Ashmen, but also to his own kin, the Eterna. And so it came to pass that he ordered the death of all life, disgruntled by his own creation. From his fingertips flew lightning bolts, which destroyed palaces and temples alike. And everyone who looked upon his countenance became consumed by madness, and thrust a sword into his neighbor's breast, and then his own. So it was that the Ashmen and Eterna perished, until no more than a few hundred remained. Verse 4. All were destined to die, and surely they would have, but the sky broke open first, and a star, gigantic and engulfed in flames, blazed down from the heavens. It shattered Pangora into six large parts and numerous splinters, and so Vin was created, the world in which we live today. He who claims to know of Asateron's destiny is a liar, as he was never seen again. Verse 5. Tired of war, the few remaining Ashmen and Eterna scattered across the continents. The grudge harbored by those born from ash against the long-lived Eterna was great, however their weariness and exhaustion after Asateron's bloody rage was even greater. So the Ashmen blended with the Eterna, and their blood became impure. The tips of their ears shrunk, and their longevity shortened to little more than a century. Even their gift of magic was extinguished, and became a shadow of what Asateron had bestowed upon them. Verse 6. A new people of short stature emerged from the debris of the fallen star and called themselves Starlings. The Second Age had commenced. Verse 7. Civilizations arose on the continents and cities were built. Both humans and half-Eterna, as well as Starlings, sought peace. However, with the end of Asateron's subjugation, their fetters, which had bound them in place, had broken loose. And so an era of violence, war, and lust for power followed, as everyone hungered after the throne for power and dominion. Verse 8. For almost 4,000 years this era of chaos persisted, and once again it seemed as if life was at the very brink of destruction, since humans, Eterna, and Starlings were all unable to respect one another and live in harmony and peace. Nevertheless, one day, a light appeared in the sky, and with it seven figures, as large as towers. The people bombarded it with magic and arrows, blinded by their thirst for blood and depravity. But no fireball, no crossbow's bolt, could cut through to the figures. Thus men laid down their arms and fell to their knees, as they realized they were facing gods. All seven rose to speak, their voices chaste and clear as purest crystal. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Path, Tome 1, The Chaos.